Hello and welcome to another episode of Bruin Blitz, where we bring you up to date on the latest games and news in Belmont Athletics. I'm your host, Emily Proud. The track team completed its indoor season at the OVC Indoor Championships held Friday and Saturday. The men's team earned 20 top 15 finishes and earned 6th place as a team, while the women recorded 18 top 20 finishes and finished 8th as a team. Highlights include senior Marcus Bridger-Wilkinson, who took 5th in the 800 meter in the first round, but was unable to continue for finals due to illness. Freshman Caleb Corpru set a Belmont record in the 60 meter hurdles, taking 5th. Austin Landis took 5th in the weight throw and 6th in the shot put, while Del McSpadden earned 8th place in the weight throw. For the women, Hannah Whitman earned 2 second place finishes, one in the 5,000 meter and another in the mile. The junior also collected a bronze medal in the 3,000 meter. Junior Jesse Wynn broke a Belmont record in the 800 meter and went on to earn 8th place overall in the event. Emily Davis took 4th in the 400 meter. The distance medley relay team, including Kiera Weems, Anna Kerrigan, Megan Hunning, and Jessica King, crushed a Belmont record set in 2009 by more than 5 seconds to earn 3rd place. Softball's game against Lipscomb was canceled on Wednesday, along with the Frost Classic in Chattanooga over the weekend due to weather. The team was able to pick up 4 games as part of the 2015 Sand Dollar Snow Classic in Gulf Shores, Alabama. The Bruins earned split results over the weekend, starting on Saturday with a 12-1 loss in 5 innings to Bradley, followed by an impressive 13-11 win over Alabama A&M. The next day, the Bruins beat Wright State 8-7, and then in a much closer game, they fell 2-1 to Bradley. The baseball team was finally able to play, but unfortunately went on a 4-game losing streak over the past week. The streak began with a 4-1 dropped contest to Tennessee on Wednesday, then unable to rebound, the team lost to Notre Dame 6-4 on Friday. The Bruins traveled to Macon, Georgia over the weekend and lost to Akron 8-3 on Saturday and Mercer 5-4 on Sunday. Earlier in the week, women's basketball earned its 300th victory in the NCAA era as they pulled out all the stops in an 84-70 win over Eastern Kentucky. Belmont recorded its highest point total in conference play this season and received a large contribution from freshman guard Sierra Jones, who finished the night with a career-high 23 points. Looking to continue its success into the weekend, the Bruins geared up for a senior night doubleheader against Tennessee State. Unfortunately, the team had trouble shooting in the second half, which led to a 70-53 loss. Before the game, seniors Blair Bryce, Katie Carroll, Natalie Kohlmeyer, Jordan Luffman-Hartsfield, Taylor Mills, Adrian Torrance, and Tori Vaught were honored in their final home game of their careers. The Belmont men's team followed with an exciting performance to finish the regular season. Belmont started off strong with an 8-0 lead and didn't slow down as they pushed past TSU 88-62. Seniors Reese Chamberlain, Holden Mobley, and Spencer Turner were also recognized as part of the senior night celebration. Men's tennis fell 4-1 to UAB on Sunday in Birmingham. The lone win came from number 4, Robin DeMasi. The women's team also struggled to produce results as well as they dropped a contest to Evansville 6-1 at the Brentwood Swim and Tennis Club. Belmont won with its number 1 doubles team made up of sophomore Lindsay Whitehead and junior Kendall Warren. In other news, the men's tennis team was picked by the league coaches to win the OVC championships for the 2015 season. Also, senior Mauricio Antun was named the top male on the OVC's preseason top 10 players list. The women's rankings were also posted on Thursday, and Belmont was placed 10th in the poll. Coming up in sports, baseball begins a 5-game homestand this week. The team faces Quinnipiac on Friday at 4 p.m. and Saturday at 2 p.m. Finally, they play Sunday against Bradley at 2 p.m. The basketball OVC tournament begins this week on Thursday with the women facing Jacksonville State at 12 p.m. at the Municipal Auditorium. If they win, they play again on Friday at 12 p.m. and with a win in that game, they will compete in the championship match at 1 p.m. on Saturday. The men's team will also compete at Municipal on Thursday. Tip-off is set for 8 p.m. against the winner of Eastern Illinois and SIU Edwardsville. With a win, the Bruins will compete in the semifinals at 8:30 p.m. against Eastern Kentucky on Friday. The game will be broadcasted on ESPNU. The championship match will be played Saturday at 6 p.m. and that game will be on ESPN2. Good luck to both teams on their tournament runs this weekend. Men's tennis is back home competing against Ball State at 2 p.m. on Friday. The women's team will play the following day in Nashville against South Dakota State at 10 a.m. Softball travels to Rock Hill, South Carolina this weekend to compete in the Winthrop tournament. Play begins Saturday against Albany at 10 a.m. and then continues at 12 p.m. versus Furman. The team also plays Sunday against Western Carolina at 9 a.m., then again against Winthrop at 11 a.m. Men's golf team continues its spring season in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina for the Bash of the Beach tournament on Monday and Tuesday. The women's team tees off its season also on Monday at the UNF Invitational in Jacksonville, Florida. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Bruin Blitz. And because of spring break next week, there will be no Bruin Blitz. But check back the following Wednesday for an all-new episode at BelmontVision.com. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at sports@BU for all the latest Belmont athletic news. I'm Emily Proud, and go Bruins!